Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. As-salatu, as-salamu ala Rasulihi al-Kareem, Sayyidi al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina wa Nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, all praise and thanks to Allah Azza wa Jal for allowing us to be here today, and all things due to Him, and peace be upon our Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his family members, and his companions. There is a particular Prophet of Allah whom the Quran gives a huge amount of attention to. Not only do we know about his years as a Prophet, we even know his years as a youngster. We even know the very events leading up to his birth. We know his mother, his brother, his sister, his father-in-law, and his wife, and even the very amount of dowry, the mahar, that he paid for his marriage. Mentioned in the Quran 183 times in the Book of Allah across about 25 different passages, it is none other than the Prophet of Allah, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And there are three unique descriptions given to the Prophet Musa that were not given to any other Prophet in the Quran. The first of them, Allah said about him, وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي, I have cast a garment of love over you. Meaning, everyone who saw him loved him, according to one of the interpretation. The second unique description given to this Prophet of Musa, when Allah said to him, وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي, so that you will be nurtured under my eye. And the third unique description given to this honorable Prophet of Allah is وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي, I have created you for myself, Allah said to him. What type of a human being, what type of a person, will a person become when he is prepared by Allah to be for Allah? The outcome is none other than the Prophet of Allah, Musa. A man whose essence, his yearnings, his ambitions were nothing but for Allah. No part of Musa was for the world of this dunya. Shaykh al-Sa'di, he said in the tafsir of this ayah, وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي, I prepared you for myself. He said, if a human being wants to prepare another mortal human being whom he loves and wants to raise him, nurture him, to reach the levels of perfection, he will use all the resources he has and he might still not be able to do so. What therefore do you think Allah Al-Qawi, Al-Aziz, the most able, the most powerful, what he would do for someone, a person whom he wants to raise to the highest levels of perfection? وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي. And when did Musa alayhi salam hear these words? He heard these words during one of the most loneliest periods in his life, when him and his wife were traveling the desert with basic provisions to just get by. Traveling the earth lost for direction, they see a glimmer of light. Musa says to his wife, Umkuthu, wait here for a moment. Inni anastu nara, I see a glimmer of light, maybe a fire. La'alli atikum minha biqabas, perhaps I'll bring you a torch of fire from it. Aw ajidu ala nari huda, or maybe someone will just give us some guidance to help us navigate this terrain. Unbeknown to Musa, however, he was not making his way to a fire. He was being called by Allah Jalla Jalaluhu to stand in the sacred valley of Tuwa to speak to Malikul Muluk, the King of Kings, the owner of sovereignty, and the possessor of all dominion, Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. he stands and he hears the words, the voice of Ar-Rahman saying to him, Ya Musa, innani ana Allah, tis me, Allah. And now, all of a sudden, Musa alayhi salam receives closure. Answers that he needed throughout his whole life. He had suffered. And up until this moment, he had no idea why he was going through so much suffering. He was born a male child in the rule of the affair where every male child was up for execution. He then was separated from his mother at the age of suckling to be raised in a home which was not his. His sister would then travel the riverbank, and when she saw that the baby was in the house of the enemy, she would say, Do you not want me to tell you about someone who can breastfeed this baby? Then Musa would become a man and accidentally kill another man. And now he's a fugitive, on the run, running from authorities, escaping the country in terror. Then he would find a wife to marry, and the mahar, the dowry, 10 years of arduous labor. Why? Why all this suffering? He needed answers. And now, as he stares into the evening night sky, looking above him and hearing the beautiful voice of Ar-Rahman, answers are finally given to him. What does Musa hear? He hears these words documented in the Quran, so you can imagine it and benefit from his treasures. He hears, قَالَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. Oh Musa, we have responded to your request yet again. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى. And we have bestowed our favor over you yet again. إِذْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ مَا يُوحَى. When we send inspiration to you, to your mother, أَنْ يَقْضِ فِيهِ فِي التَّابُوتِ, saying to your mother, put the baby in the basket, فَقْضِ فِيهِ فِي الْيَمِ, and then put the basket in the river. فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ بِالسَّاحِلِ, then the river will take him to the shore. يَأْخُذُهُ عَدُوٌ لِي وَعَدُوٌ لَهُ, where an enemy of his and an enemy of mine will take him. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي, and have cast a garment of love over you. إِذْ تَمْشِي وَلِتُصْنَى عَلَى عَيْنِي, so that you will be nurtured under my eye. إِذْ تَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ فَتَقُولُ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ يَكْفُلُهُ. And remember Musa, when your sister followed and she said the river, and she said to them, shall I not tell you of someone who can take care of this baby? فَرْجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمَّكَ, and then we returned you back to your mother. كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنَ, so that her eye can rest and she would not grieve it. وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسَ, and remember Musa, when you kill someone, فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمْ, but we saved you from retaliation. وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَ, and we have tested you with severe tests. فَلَبِثْتَ سِنِينَ فِي أَهْلِ مَدْيَنَ, and then Musa, you spent many years with the people of Madian. ثُمَّ جِئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرِي يَا مُوسَى, and then you came to this place at the decreed time. وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي, and I prepared you for myself. So now he understood all of his sufferings in his life was not in vain. It was a preparation for this moment to become a Nabi, a prophet of Allah. And now finally his heart settles. Now as a Muslim, when you hear the story of Musa, and I'm sure you have heard it before, you ask yourself the question, how can I be a person like Musa? Someone who is created by Allah to be for Allah. I would love to be this person whom Allah loves, cares, nurtures, helps against enemies, gives answers, gives him security in the day of judgment, and gives him the highest level of paradise. How can I be a person who is prepared by Allah to be for Allah? I share with you five signs that your sufferings as a Muslim is not going to waste and your sacrifice will be thanked by Allah Jalla Jalalu. Five signs, and we take them from the biography of Musa alayhi salam. And as I say this, try to measure yourself against these five. Number one, you have an unquenchable thirst for knowledge. This was Musa. We all know the story of Musa alayhi salam and his teacher. When he came to learn that there was a man more knowledgeable than him, he said, La abrah, I will not stop traveling hatta ablugha majma' al-bahrain, until I come, and even if it takes me many years, till I arrive at the junction of the two seas, aw amdiya huquba, even if it takes me many years, I will find this man and I will learn from this man. And when he came to his mentor, who was less than him in status, but he had much more knowledge, he said, هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا? Do you mind if I accompany you to learn from some of the sound judgment Allah has given you? عن معاوية قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the deen. So this is sign number one to measure yourself against. Are you a man, a woman, chosen by Allah to be for Allah? Tell me about your thirst for knowledge. Number two, you have a strong commitment to ibadah in its all forms. The very first words Musa alayhi salam heard from Allah Jalla Jalalu in the valley of Tua was, فَاعْبُدْنِي, worship me. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي, and establish the prayer for my remembrance. So that's sign number two to measure yourself against. What kind of abid, what kind of worshipper are you? Become an exemplar worshipper. When people are eating, you are fasting. When people are sleeping, you're standing in qiyam. When people are gossiping and busy on their socials, you are busy with the remembrance of Allah. That's sign number two, that you are a worshipper in times of ease and in times of hardship, in times of difficulty and prosperity, in times of happiness and sadness. Your motto in life is salah, dhikr, Quran, qiyam. A sign that Allah has chosen you to be for Him. Sign number three, you have a fearless ability to acknowledge your personal errors. There are certain mistakes that we have done in our past that we should have asked forgiveness for 5 years ago, 10 years ago. But Musa alayhi salam was not this man. When he made a mistake, he was quick to say, Astaghfirullah. This is from shaitan. And he would make the changes in his life to fix that. When he saw two men fighting and he underestimated his own power and pushed the man and the man died, he didn't say, okay, he deserved that. He deserved that. He is always causing trouble, he's always causing problems, always getting into fight. No. What did he say? He said, هذا من عمل الشيطان. This is from shaitan. إِنَّهُ عَدُوٌ مُضِلٌ مُبِينٌ. He's an enemy, openly leading people astray. So what did he say? He said, وَبِّغْفِرْ لِي. My Lord, forgive me. فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. Allah said, I forgive you. And this Allah is, and innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. Allah is the forgiving and merciful. So this is sign number three to measure yourself against. How you feel when someone advises you? How do you feel when you are listening to a lecture, a khutbah, a talk, whatever it may be, and someone's giving you some advice? What do you do? What is your reaction? Are you straight, you thinking right away to say something back? Say something back to the person to give them a, you know, payback of their own medicine? Or are you someone who's taking the advice and reflecting upon it? If you find yourself accepting the mistake, acknowledging your error, and rushing to solve and fix the problems, abishir, good news. This is sign number three in your life that Allah is preparing you to be for Him. Sign number four, you have an unbreakable ethic of sabr, patience. Before he left Egypt and after, Musa alayhi salam suffered in every aspect of his life. وَلَمْ يُرَى إِلَّا صَابِرًا مُحْتَسِبًا. Yet, he was only ever seen patient. And in fact, his patience was so great that our Prophet ﷺ saw him as an example. And when things became tough for the Prophet ﷺ and people harmed him, he would say, رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ أَخِي مُوسَى. May Allah have mercy on my brother Musa. لَقَدَ أُوذِيَ بِأَكْثَرَ مِنْ هَذَا فَصَبَرَ. He suffered more than this, but he was always seen patient. Patience with the commandments of Allah, patience with the decree of Allah, patience with the painful decree, the painful qadr, the sign number 4 to measure yourself against. And sign number 5, and your 5th sign to measure yourself, to see whether you're being prepared by Allah, to be for Allah. You have this desire to be of service to others. Musa sees 2 people fighting, he has to get involved. He has to try to resolve. He did this twice when he went to Madian and he saw 2 women who can't shove and push against men to water their cattle. He took the initiative. He took the initiative, he got them water and he returned it back. And even when he was studying under his teacher, he saw things that he didn't like. He had to say something. He had to say something. So Musa was a man of ihsan, a man of excellence, and wanting to serve not just only his ambitions and his career, but also others. So what did Allah say? وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَاسْتَوَى. Allah says when he reached his full age of maturity and became a man, آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. We gave him wisdom and knowledge. Why? وَكَذَلِكَ نَجِزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Because Musa was a man who is of excellence, of service to others. So these are 5 signs to measure yourself against whether you're being prepared by Allah to be for Allah. And we said number 1, a thirst for knowledge. Number 2, a commitment to ibadah. Number 3, a fearless acknowledgement of your personal errors. Number 4, an ethic of sabr. You're not quick to snap. And number 5, you have a longing to be of khidmah, of service to others. As a believers, when we hear stories like this documented in the Quran, we should always try our best and think ways to improve our life, and to improve our life in the sense connecting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at a deeper level. And there are even more lessons we can derive from the life of Musa alayhi salam. Even there is even something we can derive from the mother of Musa and the dire situation she was put in after the birth of Musa. Upon his birth, to protect him from the Pharaoh, Musa was placed in a basket and was cast into the river. Imagine this for a moment. We know the relationship, how sacred the relationship is of a mother and a child. Especially in the early ages, you never see them separated. The mother will unconditionally love her child and do whatever, sacrificing herself, her health, anything to take care of the child. So now imagine how difficult was this for the mother of Musa. She didn't know that Musa was going to end up somewhere. To save Musa, she had faith in Allah and she put him into the river. Allah says, وَأَصْبَحَ فُؤَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا إِن كَادَتْ لَتُبْدِي بِهِ لَوْلَا أَنْ رَبَطْنَا عَلَى قَلْبِهَا لَوْلَا أَنْ رَبَطْنَا عَلَى قَلْبِهَا لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And the heart of the mother of Musa ached so much that she almost gave away his identity. Had we not reassured her heart in order to have her faith in Allah's promise? So what can we learn from this? If you ever feel like you cannot overcome an obstacle, then do what the mother of Musa did. By returning to Allah and asking for his help, any and every tragedy can be overcome. Her love for Allah, her trust in Allah, overcame her worries. Because Allah said, we will take care of Musa. She had that conviction in his plan and knew that that plan had no time limit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never specified a time of return. Allah never said, put him into the basket and I'll return him to you in a few days. He never said that. But she had the conviction and trust in Allah's plan. And in that process of hardship and struggles, of grief, you're learning to love Allah. You're learning how to trust His plan. Maybe just the reason for this test was you to fall in love with Allah, for you to reach out to Him, call to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't leave you hanging. He provides you solutions in ways you never saw coming. Musa alayhi salam didn't know, but every aspect of his life, from the birth to the end, Allah helped him navigate throughout his life. Difficult situations, but he had trust in Allah and Allah helped him. So ultimately, it is trusting in Allah's plan and also His timing. We cannot become hastened when we make a dua and say, oh Allah, I made the dua, where's my answer? We cannot become like that. We have to be of those who are patient, and we have to be continuously going back to Allah, and Allah's help is near. Muawiyah bin Hayda al-Qushayri radiallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أنتم توفون سبعين أمة أنتم خيرها وأكرمها على الله. You, O Muslims, are the last of 70 nations Allah has created. Yet in the eyes of Allah, you are the greatest and most noble of all those nations. But let's address the elephant in the room and be honest. When we hear narrations like this, we can't help but wonder, where is this loved and most precious nation to Allah? Where is it? Because wherever you are to look around the world, all you can see is suffering, bruises, and carnage. You turn to China and you see the Uyghur Muslims. You see their plight continuing and an ethnic cleansing. Then you turn to Myanmar, Burma, and you see the Rohingyas, and their plight is continuing. And now you look to Bangladesh, a Muslim majority country, killing their own people. And then you look towards India, what seems to be a genocide making its way to them. And then you look to Yemen, and you see a famine that is threatening the existence of the whole country. And then you look to Syria, a decade-long war that has destructed the whole country. And then you look to Palestine, you see corruption at its core, and you see the struggle, and you see a siege and an illegal occupation. And then you look to Gaza, and you see your biggest open-air prison today. And then you look to Al-Aqsa, and we see our third holiest site being desecrated in front of the whole international community. Where is this favored nation? And how is it that these are the people in the eyes of Allah who are so loved? But yet, wherever you are to look, all you see is pain, suffering, and carnage and destruction. For those who ask how and why, the response is the same as what Musa alayhi salam received. He was told, وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي. I am preparing you for myself. The same way that the suffering of Musa alayhi salam wasn't because Allah hated him or that Allah abandoned him, but because he was being prepared to lead Bani Israel out of Egypt. We are to see our pain and our sufferings in the same manner. Allah has not abandoned us, and neither has He hated us. These are preparatory events to allow the Muslims to lead humanity. مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا خَلَى. And the process of Musa for leadership, preparing Musa for leadership, is the same process that we shall go through. What was the process? Separated from his mother, separated from the places he loved, separated from the places and the people he loved. we too will be separated from the people and the places we love, even if it may be Al-Qasa. But Musa alayhi salam was reunited with the places he loved and the people he loved. And Allah has promised we too shall be reunited with the people and the places we love. The waves that bashed, the waves of the river now that bashed against the basket of Musa are no different than the pain and the suffering that the Muslims around the world face today. But the shore of River Nile was close to Musa, and our help is also near. Allah says, Ala inna nasrullahi qareeb, the help of Allah is close. He said, Inna alladhina yuhadduna Allah wa rasulahu ulaika fil adhallin. Those who oppose Allah and His messengers, they will be the debased ones. كتب الله لأغلبن أنا ورسلي إن الله قوي عزيز. Allah has already decreed that I, Allah, and messengers will overcome and we shall prevail. Indeed, Allah is almighty, Allah is wise. We ask Allah that He allows us to have faith in Him and His plan and His timing, and that we always, despite our hardships, we always go back to Him. We always ask Him and not to lose hope in Him. We ask that He forgives us and that He gives us Jannah for those. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.